morning, everyone.
Good morning.
All right, well, happy full moon in Lammas. And a powerful day. It's called Lunar Lammas. We have solar Lammas and lunar Lammas. So it's a cross-quarter holy day, which is the midday point between the summer solstice and the fall equinox in the north, or the winter solstice and spring equinox in the southern hemisphere. And in the northern hemisphere, so from here, the days start getting shorter, like signaling the change in seasons, and it's also the beginning of harvest season. Celebrate it kind of as a grain harvest, some of the grains of the wheat are ready to be harvested, and bake bread and have a bonfire and celebrate the life-giving power of the sun and sunflowers, fire rituals, and just enjoying whatever is ready for harvest from your garden. And so taking some time to connect with nature. And also being the full moon, the moon is in Aquarius, the sun is in Leo. Leo is kind of shining your light in a kind of personal way, rising into your own maturity and majesty and the way you give and serve. And then Aquarius is like the Aquarian mind, so it's helping us to tap into the age of Aquarius, which we are living into, and a time of kind of rethinking and reinventing ourselves, obviously, and becoming more like the global family as opposed to the just individual ego, my needs, our needs, and how. So we're very interesting this time of COVID and this time of things that, things are shifting and changing. And we need each other more than ever. And a lot of interesting collaborations and new ways of being are emerging. So celebrating that and welcoming that. I mean, those shifts and change can be uncomfortable and kind of scary. And honoring that wherever it breaks down, wherever there's a breakdown, breakthrough is inevitable, kind of chaos theory. So just recognizing we are in this time, and it's really about, I say this time, Uranus is having a square to the moon and the sun, and Uranus is about higher consciousness, the higher mind, and it can be very disruptive. A lot of unexpected surprises. So figuring how to roll with the punches and take good care of yourself, and also to be firm in your spiritual practices, whatever it is that helps you to stay calm and centered, and to release any anxiety, stress, and just to know that we are kind of tumbled around, and know that we can reach down into our spiritual toolkits and find those things that can help us through the storm. Right? Anyone share?
It's a magical day in the neighborhood. And the most important part of this beautiful summer, as we come into our summer, is to recognize that the light is shining for us, and that we are all here for a divine purpose, and that we all are empowered beings that are here to make a reflection onto Earth. So with that being said, let's enjoy this magical moment that we're all having together.
Better if I get my headset. 212. Here it comes. Ah, all right, that should be better. So I'll just talk a little bit more about, as you might have seen our newsletter that we sent out a couple of days ago about Lammas and about this being a time to, on a personal level, to, you know, reflect on what you've harvested this year and to reflect on what is still growing in your garden of life and tending to that, providing it any extra nourishment or attention it needs, weeding away anything that might be choking off life, cutting away all that's no longer serving, anything that's distracting, and really taking stock into how can you best stay focused. And on those things that you're stirring into being. And really the things that we are, this is kind of almost like a new moon time, the things that we, if we are able to stay really focused and clear right now and follow those promptings that we have for things that want to be created through us, even new things, and by in 6 months from now, when we get to kind of the new moon in Aquarius, those things will start to be bearing fruit. So what is it now that you are, what are you seeding now? What is calling you? What opportunities are arising for you? So I said, don't despair. We are going to get there. And we are the one that we've been waiting for. Sound much better in just a moment. Here we go. So, all right, we're just bring the speaker a little closer. So I encourage you to write down your intentions, or really focus on, here we go. Yeah.
Okay. Take two.
It's nice to have a little power behind us. I can really feel it now.
And you know, Heather's usually very shy on the mic, but years of training.
It's got me right, front and center. Right, so I invite you to, encourage you to write down those things, maybe even sketch or draw, in this time of Leo, fire is a powerful element to use, burning away, clearing anything that's no longer serving, and using the power of the sun to really take in and charge up those. See yourself as a big seed of possibility. I heard a saying a while ago. They tried to bury us, but they didn't know we were seeds. And so we just grew up anyways through the darkness and the challenges and all of it. Come sitting up nice and tall, lengthening through the spine, lift through your heart, close your eyes, turning your awareness within. Bring your awareness to your breath and begin to follow your breath as it goes in and out. Softening your face, your jaw, your shoulders.
deepening your breath into the area of your heart. Noticing what's alive for you this morning, this afternoon, this day. Set an intention for your day and for your practice. Deepening your breath into the area of your belly. And all the way down to your root chakra and at the base of your spine. And all the way down to the center of the earth. It's tuning into inner earth. Bring your awareness back to your root chakra and let's send down a brand new grounding cord for the day. And again, this grounding cord can look like anything, a rope, a tube, a root, whatever your grounding cord is looking like is just perfect, just making sure it's really well connected at your root chakra in the center of the earth. Give yourself a nice little energy flush down that grounding cord, releasing all that's no longer serving mentally, emotionally, physically, spiritually. Envisioning a beautiful golden sun over top of your head as we call in our highest creative essence. Calling in all of your gifts, your talents, your purpose, your power, your passion. Draw this energy in through the top of your head, let it come spiraling in through and around you, completely filling you with light. Let it go down into the earth. As you're ready, just bend over and shake it out a little bit and come rolling back up with hands in prayer at your heart. And let's chant three ohms together, the root sound of all sound, to begin. I invite you to explore the full resonance of the sound, beginning with ah in the heart, raise it to oh in the throat, and then mm on the lips. And we'll do three rounds. Let's inhale to begin. Into our practice this morning, giving ourselves the gift of our awareness, our presence, our love. May we take this time to deeply heal and nourish, restore and reset, creating peace and balance within, as within, so without. Namaste. Imploding your hands to your knees, your palms can be face down, taking a moment to breathe into that heart chakra. Breathing in and out through that heart. Tuning into that eternal flame that dwells within. Nourish it with your awareness and fan it with your love. By repeating found something you are grateful for in this moment, something that brings a smile to your heart. It could be something you love doing, or someone you love, or somewhere you love being. Connecting with the state of being of spirit, of joy, connects you with the state of being of spirit. And allow that beautiful golden light of that flame to expand out and radiate to all of your cells, to your entire being. Let's send this out. Let it touch and bless someone you'd like it to reach or somewhere. And let's send this to the whole planet, the people of the earth. To yourself and allow to bless you up a thousandfold. Now simply bow your head to your heart. Tuck your chin, let your head hang heavy, bowing your head, your mind to be in service of the way of the heart. In service of the way of compassion and empathy and healing and love. And if your mind wanders, bring it back. Take a couple more breaths. Slowly and gently roll the head around to the right. Right ear comes towards the right shoulder. Gently lifting as you go to the back. Left ear, left shoulder. Take it back to the front. Again, inhale, right ear, right shoulder. Gently lifting as you go to the back. Left ear, left shoulder. Take it back to the front. One more this time, this way, inhale. Take it the other direction. Inhale. Left ear, left shoulder, gently lifting as you go to the back. And exhale. And one more. Inhale. And exhale. Bow your head back to your heart. Slowly and gently arch and flex the spine. We're going to inhale, take it forward, open through the front of your body, lift through your chin, drop your shoulders. Exhale, take it back, curl your tailbone under, curve your spine, bow your head to your heart. Inhaling forward, opening through the front of your body. Exhale back, curl your tailbone under, bow your head to your heart. Keep moving a few more at your own pace. Inhaling forward, exhaling back. Gently opening and lubricating that spine. center, lengthen through your spine, lift through your heart, anchor your sit bones into the ground. And now let's take a nice big circle. Inhale as you spiral towards the front, exhaling as you move towards the back, breathing nice and long and deep. Inhaling as you spiral towards the front, exhaling as you move towards the back. Direction again, inhale as you spiral towards the front, exhaling as you move towards the back, breathing nice and long and deep. Good. Now let's come spiraling our way to center, making your circle smaller and smaller until you center yourself. Place the right hand on the mat beside you. Inhale the left arm up and overhead. Nice side stretch, opening through your side body. And inhale up. Let's take it to the other side. And inhale up the other side. And flap your hands, or hold, if you have any shoulder issues, just hold your arms straight, make a little fist with your thumbs, and thumbs facing each other, okay? This is a little more active like this. Let's move this energy. Inhale to begin. Squeeze the anus and all the energy up. Hold, hold, hold. Squeeze. And exhale with a ha. Just combing through your aura. Releasing any energy to the earth. Any tension, stress, strain. We'll do a little tapping this morning. So just take your fingers, tips, and tap top of your head and tap your whole skull, nice firm tap, releasing, loosening up the mind, releasing any tension, any worry, any frustration or stress. Good, let's move to above the eyebrows, nice firm tap. Good. Let's move to the third eye point. Nice firm tap. And if you have anything you're releasing, emotional freedom technique, something, even though I may have frustration or stress, I still unconditionally love and accept myself. Even though I might have anxiety or worry, I still unconditionally love myself. Move to your temple. These cleansing breaths move through your, underneath your eyes to your high cheekbones. Let's move to the upper lip, above the upper lip. Move to the outside corners of the lip. Let's move to underneath the bottom lip. Let's move to the neck and the occiput. Nice tapping. And even maybe give your neck a little squeeze. Squeeze out any tension. To the thymus gland. Give yourself a nice little thymus gland. And now to the collarbones. Take both hands. Wow. I must be moving some energy. Underneath the underarm, get one side, and then let's go to the other side, and let's go to the belly. I'm wondering if batteries are done. Let me change the battery.
Yeah.
Turn it off. Just follow along. We're changing the battery. Business. All right.
Okay.
And give yourself a nice little energy wash. It's kind of hot. Let's do a little alternate nostril breathing. So take your right thumb and press it against your right nostril. And take your left thumb and index finger touching together your left thumb and index finger. And press it against your right nostril and exhale out your left for four. And now inhale through your left for four. And now take your ring and pinky finger and plug the left nostril. Both nostrils are plugged. And hold for four. And exhale through the right for four. And inhale through the right for four. And hold for four. Plug the right for four. And exhale through the left for four. And inhale through the left for four. And hold, close the left for four, hold the breath. And exhale through the right for four. And inhale through the right for four. And hold, plug the right for four, hold the breath. And exhale through the left for four. And inhale through the left for four. And hold, plug for four. Exhale through the right for four. Inhale through the right for four. Two more rounds. Hold for four. Plug the right. And exhale through the left for four. Inhale through the left for four. Plug, hold the breath for four. Exhale through the right for four. Inhale through the right for four. Hold the breath for four. Exhale through the left for four. Last one. Inhale through the left for four. Plug and hold the breath for four. Exhale through the right for four. And release that hand. Come into Kiyam Mudra. Thumb and four fingers touching both hands. And lungs center yourself, noticing any shifts in your energy. Release, and now just shake your legs out. Give them a nice little shake, lengthening them out. And we are going to come into child's pose towards the back of the mat. Bring your seat to your heel, your forehead to your mat. And you can bring your arms along your sides and just bow to the earth. And have your knees spread nice and wide if you like. Just take a moment to send the earth some gratitude and appreciation. Giving thanks for all the beautiful life upon the earth and all the ways that the earth sustains us. Thank you. Inhale, come rolling on up. Nice and slow. Sitting onto your heels. And now inhaling all the way up onto your knees, sweep your arms out and up. Reach for a beautiful golden sun. Inhale, exhale, draw that solar energy down into the earth. Come down to all fours, hands and knees. Hands underneath your shoulders, knees hip width apart. Spread your fingers wide. Inhale, sink through, look up towards the sky. Exhale, curl your tailbone under, curve your spine, bow your head to your heart. Inhale, sink through, look up. Exhale, curl. Couple more, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale to a flat back. Let's do a couple of hip roll circles. So circle your hips all the way to the right. Circle back around to your heels, wide and around to the left and forward. And again to the right and back. And left and forward. To the right and back. And left and forward. To the right and back. And left and forward, and right and back, and left and forward. Good. Take it the other direction, left and back, and right and forward, left and back, and right and forward, and again, left and back, and right. And as you exhale, nice lion's breath, stick out your tongue, look up to the sky. Inhale again, curl up. And exhale. Two more. Inhale. Curl up. And exhale. And last one. Inhale, curl up. And exhale. Shake it out. A couple of bear rolls. Let your upper body go. And maybe even fill your lips or your tongue. Just getting into those shoulders. A little freeze form movement. And inhaling back up. And inhale, right arm up to the side. Look at your hand. And exhale, thread the needle, lower yourself down, side of your head comes to your mat. And take whatever variation you like here, perhaps extend that left arm straight out in front, or maybe even lift it up to the sky and wrap it around your body, whatever feels good to you. Couple more breaths. And inhale, back up, bring that arm all the way back through and up, look at your hand, and exhale down. And let's do the other side. Inhale, left arm up, look at your hand, exhale, thread the needle, lower yourself down, side of your head comes to your mat. And extend that arm, other arm straight out, or maybe raise it up and wrap it around your body. Whatever feels good for you this morning. Good. Inhale back up. Bring that arm back through and up. Look at your hand once again. And exhale down. From here, we're going to inhale, draw the right knee into the forehead. Exhale out, bend and lengthen the left. Inhale in, squeeze. Exhale out, extend, lengthen lift. Inhale in, squeeze. Exhale out, extend, lengthen lift. Inhale in, squeeze. Exhale out, extend, lengthen lift. And three more. Inhale in. Exhale out. Inhale in. Exhale out. And one more. Inhale in. And exhale out and hold, hold, hold. And inhale. Left arm comes up. Extend. Find your balance. And exhale everything down. Bring that right leg all the way through to a nice long lunge. And get this knee over the ankle and bring your arms to the inside. Okay. If you want to come down to your forearms, you can for a deeper opening. Bring that hip flexor.
I forgive.
Inhale, let's take it forward one more time. And bring your arms all the way up this time, all the way up. Nice deep lunge. Bring your hands to prayer at the heart. And twist, opposite elbow to knee, left elbow to right knee. Chaturanga, inhale cobra or upward dog, exhale downward dog, inhale drop your knees to your mat, exhale push back to your heels with a nice long child pose, inhale back up to all fours, hands and knees, second side, inhale left knee into the forehead, exhale extend. Inhale in, squeeze. Exhale out, extend. Inhale in, squeeze. Exhale out, extend. Inhale in, squeeze. Exhale out, extend. And four more. Inhale in, squeeze. Exhale out, extend. Inhale in, squeeze. Exhale out, extend. Two more. Inhale in. Exhale out. Last one. Inhale in. Exhale out and hold, hold, hold. Inhale, right arm up, find your balance. And exhale that hand down. Bring this leg all the way through to a nice long lunge. Good. Both arms come to the inside and sink down into it.
All that I am, all that I am, all
Inhale, back up. Bring your arms to either side. And lengthen that leg out. Flex the foot. Sinking into it. And inhale, take it forward once again. Arms all the way up now. Find your balance, sink. Hands to prayer at the heart and twist. Left elbow, right elbow, left knee. Toes. Inhale, push up to a downward dog and press it out. Then one knee and then the other. Good. Press both heels to the mat. Inhale to push up plank. Exhale, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, drop your knees to your mat. Exhale, push your seat back to your heels. Inhale, come rising up onto your knees. Sweep your arms out and up. Reach for the sun. Exhale, draw the solar energy in through the crown of your head. Bring your hands to prayer and your seat to heels. Envision sitting in the center of a beautiful golden sun. And exhale, release. And come all the way lying down onto your back. Good, and let's draw the right knee into the chest. Give it a nice hug. Extend your right arm out to the side and draw this knee across the body to the floor, the opposite side, stacking your hips, gazing over your right shoulder. And take this right arm and slowly and gently circle it around the body, nice and slow. One inhale. One exhale for each rotation. Opening through the shoulder and the chest. And take it the other direction. And inhale, draw your knee back into your chest. And exhale, lengthen that leg out and give a nice little shake. Now the other side, inhale. Left knee into the chest, give it a nice hug. Extend your left arm out to the side. And draw this knee across the floor to the opposite side. Nice spinal twist once again. Good. And this time we're going to take the left arm and slowly and gently circle it around the body. One inhale, one exhale for each rotation. Thank you. take it the other direction. And inhale, draw your knee back into your chest. And lengthen it out. Nice little shake. And lastly, let's bring both legs into the chest. And reach down to the bottom outsides of both feet. And come into a nice happy baby pose. Feet are parallel to each other and to the sky. Just kind of roll it side to side for a moment. Let's come back to center. Let's open those legs nice and wide to a nice wide split. Maybe holding onto your big toes or maybe just only holding onto your legs somewhere. Wherever it's easy. Five nice long deep breaths here. And gravity do the work. Feet together, wrap your hands around your feet. Let's bring those feet over towards the back of the head. And exhale, bring your feet flat to the floor. Arms along your sides, palms face down. So feet are parallel and hip width apart. Bridge pose. So we're going to inhale, press down through the feet to lift the torso up. Don't squeeze the butt. Press, use your legs. Press down through the feet. Strengthen those legs. Hold, hold, hold. And exhale, lower yourself down ever so slowly, slowly, slowly. Vertebra by vertebra. Take a couple of resting breaths. And one more time, inhale, press down to the feet, lift up, lift, lift, lift. Hold. Use those legs, keep the glutes loose. And exhale, lower yourself down slowly, slowly. Kind of just swish those legs side to side. And then just come rolling up. And I hope you find a pillow, which would be, I mean, this would be great, just a long, thin kind of pillow. And do Supta Baddha Konasana. So you're not sitting in it on it, it goes right behind. Reach tailbone. And then you're just going to lay back. And arms up, hip palms face up. And if this feels too much to have your feet together and knees apart, you can have your legs straight, or you can take pillows and put them underneath your thighs. Nice heart opening. Asana. And just sinking in. I'm going to take a few breaths here, so just sink into that. And as you sink into that, for another few breaths, I'm going to read today's passage from Opening the Doors Within. Learn to act spontaneously, to act by intuition, and to do what your heart prompts you to do. Not just what your mind tells you is reasonable and sensible. Some acts of pure love may appear to be very unreasonable, even foolish in the eyes of others, but it matters not. When you are prompted to act, do so, and do not stop to weigh it up or even wonder why you are doing it. That small act of love may have some very far-reaching effect. It may not even reveal itself to begin with. Do not waste time looking for results. Simply do what you know you must do, and then leave the rest to me. Sometimes it may take a long time for that seed of love to germinate in a hard, cold heart. But once it is planted, sooner or later it will show itself. All you have to do is to do your part in faith, and to know all is very, very well. And then just roll over to your side and take that pillow away, and then roll back onto your back for Shavasana, final relaxation. Lengthening your legs out, bring your arms along your sides, palms face up. And just sinking in. Allowing your bones to be heavy. Your muscles to fall away from your bones. And allow the earth to support you and the air to cocoon you. Now gently and slowly, bring your awareness back to your breath and your body. Just noticing your breath as it goes in and out. noticing your chest as it rises and falls. And as you're ready, you can slowly and gently wiggle your fingers and toes, bringing some energy back into your body. And perhaps taking a nice long stretch, extending your arms, your head towards the back of the wall, taking a nice long stretch. And drawing your knees into your chest, giving them a nice hug with both arms. And perhaps rolling over to your right side, taking a couple of breaths there. Slowly and gently make your way back up to seated for a close. Sitting up nice and tall, taking a moment to center yourself once again. Tuning into that grounding cord, envisioning sitting in the center of a beautiful golden sun. And fill yourself up with one more beautiful golden sun. And letting go down into the earth. And bending over and shaking it out. And bring your hands back to prayer at your heart for close. As we close with one Om this morning, let's inhale to begin. Thank you for joining us for yoga this morning. May light be your guide, may love be your way. May you find peace and balance as we dance through these turbulent energies and times. May we give great gratitude for all that we have
and
for our blessings.
We'll see you at 1 our time.
Yeah, we will be back in about 50 minutes with our sand healing journey. Thank you.
Peace.
That was fun.
Honey.
I know.